Well, I went to Uganda for a month. While I was there, I heard about what's going on in northern Uganda, which has rebels come into northern Uganda and basically turn children into soldiers.
Yeah.
And so that's what that is representing. Never actually saw it, because I was in southern Uganda, but it was something I heard about. But this is a series that I'm doing that is just representing my experience.
How long were you there?
I was there a month, and it was back in 2004.
What set you there?
Well, it was a missions trip for Oral Roberts University. So that was while I was there.
I mean, the expression on their face is so different from the ones that are in here.
Well, this one's a domestic, more of a domestic grasshopper season. They have an actual grasshopper season where they prepare grasshoppers for people to eat, and it's really good. And then there was women that prepare. They pull off the wings.
And they're probably gossiping while they.
I don't know. Maybe.
While they do or whatever, you know, just like
but,
chatting. Right?
Yeah, but this is just representation of that moment.
Because
that
kids probably have nothing to say. Like they're just probably like, I'm just doing what I'm told, right?
Yeah, pretty much. It's a pretty difficult situation of what they're in. But he was different. Like I manipulated it a lot more, but I got a basic. Photo of a boy holding a gun, so.
So let's go, we are Stevedore. Come on up, it's our last one.
It's kind of like, I guess it'd be a person, an older age person, that's just kind of oblivious to what's going on. Like they've been here for so long that you just kind of get used to, you know, he's like walking by these things that young people are making.
Yeah.
And like, he's just so oblivious to it. And he's so just used to being in this kind of like institutionalized place. So, you know, and there's a lot of people that get like that. You just get into your routine and you don't notice like what's going on around you.
Yeah.
Those colors? I think just to implement like how like a lot of people just get stuck in that routine. They're not paying attention to the colors. I mean, it's very kind of institutionalized.
We are here to kind of get our name out. It's a new company that we're starting here in Tulsa called Off-Road Artists, and this is our first performance. What we want it to be is we want it to grow into a bigger company where we collaborate with all types of artists, photographers, visual artists, musicians and everyone, but this is our first performance.
And who do you have here?
My name is Meredith Lane.
Okay.
I'm Shannon Kuykendall.
And?
Alexis Bird.
And how did each of you get involved with this idea?
Well, I know Shannon from teaching dance class. We teach dance at the same studio, so that's how I got involved with working with her.
Okay. I kind of recruited them. It was my idea to start a performing company after I talked to other artists who weren't getting the chance to showcase their work, and there's a lot of interest, and so we started it with a dance performance.
And you?
Well, I got interested because Shannon had mentioned the idea to me, and I thought it was a wonderful idea, so I joined in to support her. And she's a dancer at TU, Tulsa University,
okay,
and that's how I met her.
Wow. But,
and then I graduated from University of Oklahoma, and I moved to Tulsa. Summer, but we hope to get back together in the fall and start planning other performances then.
Okay. And do you have a website?
Yes, we do. The website is www.offroadartists.com, where you can find it on MySpace/offroadartists.
Well, really all my work is about internal sort of vague themes I've subconsciously come up with. I think that every physical object has an importance. People are always denying the importance of the material world, and I contradict that. I think that physical objects have very deep sentimental meaning, which is kind of what this piece is about. I like to go around to old shops and collect different bits of cloth that I think are interesting, and because I think pillowcases and shirts and old bits of curtains and things like that, they have an aesthetic importance to people. Like they remember things from their childhood that resemble things like that. So I think that it's a piece that everybody can relate to in a very deep subconscious sort of way. I really think Dada and just letting things be as they are, it really helped me kind of loosen up, being able to drape things like this and not being so tight and letting things fall where they do. And the whole purpose, or the whole concept of having cloth just hang as it is. And that in itself is beautiful. You don't have to stretch it, you don't have to pull it, you don't have to rip it apart in any certain way. It just, it can be as it is, and that's beautiful in itself. Yeah, I work outside because the lacquer I use is highly toxic, so I have to wear gas masks and gloves. And a bug got stuck in my lacquer, and it was already dead. I would have felt bad if it weren't, but it already was, so. It seems like flies, houseflies, always get trapped in windows, which is kind of what this is supposed to represent, is a window. So I thought it was a fitting place for it. And that's another thing, I just kind of let it lie where it was. I didn't try to control it.